Hi, and welcome back. In the previous video, we discussed mute groups and DCA groups and the benefits of each. If you're using a TouchMix 30 Pro, in addition to mute groups and DCA groups, you also have subgroups. A subgroup is similar to a DCA in that it can affect the level of multiple channels at once. The difference between DCA and subgroups is that a subgroup has the ability to apply effects and additional processing to that group of channels as well. It can do this because signal is routed through the group as opposed to a DCA, which is merely adding level or taking away level and is never at any time receiving any signal. So, by using a subgroup, we can now add EQ, limiting, compression, and effects to a group of channels. While the use of subgroups can be vast, there are three primary ways that subgroups are used. One, to apply common processing and level control to multiple inputs and return the processed group to the main left and right mix. Two, to route a group of inputs, often called stems, to an external destination. And three, to route a blend of subgroups to an external destination. Let's jump into the setup and we'll talk about these three techniques as we go. First, navigate to the subgroups bank by using the bank navigation button at the top of the screen. Here we have 8 subgroup faders. Touch the name above the fader to access the settings. Because the subgroup is receiving and processing signal, the subgroup looks very similar to an input or output channel. We have an overview screen where we can see the complete configuration of the group and have access to the most show critical controls on a single screen. We have an EQ and a limiter or a compressor, FX, aux routing, and even presets. While there are no factory presets for the subgroups, you do have the ability to save custom presets. Finally, we have the setup tab, which contains all of the assignment buttons. For most applications using subgroups, you want to unassign the channels in the group from the main left and right output. Otherwise, those channels will be delivered to the main output dry as well as through the subgroup. The toggle above the assignment buttons will allow us to automatically unassign any channels from the main output when assigned to this group. By default, this will be set to no. To enable this feature, switch it to yes. From here, we can select the channels we want to include in the subgroup. We can use the same grouping techniques we outlined in the first video, something simple like drums, guitars, keys, and vocals. Or we could make more complex groupings such as drums, guitars, keys, vocals, brass or choir, speaking mics, drama mics, background music, video playback, etc. The groupings will vary depending on the type of event, of course. If we are using technique 1, which is to apply processing to a group of channels and return it to the main left-right, we're all set. Maybe we want to put some compression on the entire drum set to glue it together a little more, or add some reverb to an entire horn or vocal section. During a speaking event, where different groups of headset or lavalier microphones are used, we can apply EQ and limiting to those groups on top of the channel EQ for each microphone. A major advantage of subgroups is that they give us an extra stage in the mix that we can use to mitigate feedback and solve overall mix issues without having to affect the main output EQ. Additionally, it leaves our channel EQs free to deal with tonal adjustments specific to the individual sources. There are advanced use cases in which having the signal go to the main output directly as well as through the subgroup is desirable. For example, if you want to employ a mixing technique called parallel compression or bus compression. Parallel compression is a common technique used in recording that can help to thicken particular instruments or sections of the mix. This technique is very commonly used on drum set and bass guitar, but can be effective on guitar or vocals as well. For this operation, we need to keep the input channels running to the mains as well as through the subgroups, instead of routing them through the subgroups only. In short, it works by sending signal to a bus and applying a heavy amount of compression to the bused signal. This compressed signal can then be blended with the dry signal in the main output, giving a considerable amount of density to the overall sound of that instrument or group of instruments. Using subgroups, we can apply this technique in a live setting as well. Pretty cool. Now, what if we want to send a subgroup to an aux? Techniques 2 and 3 both require this operation. These techniques involve routing a group of channels, or stems, to an external destination. A stem is just another name for a channel group, but is indicative of that group being sent out and away from the mixing console to another device, such as a recording or broadcast device, or even another mixer. Because a subgroup acts much like a regular channel, it can be routed to an aux the same way. From within the channel strip of the subgroup, we can press the auxes tab and route the subgroup to any aux send from there. Or from the main mix screen, we can select an aux mix on the side of the screen, press the subgroup's bank button at the top, and adjust the subgroup fader in that aux mix. With technique 2, we are only sending a single subgroup to an aux so that it can be delivered to an external device so as to send individual stems discreetly. We will do this if we need to send stems to an outboard multi-track recording device and want to capture the performance, but don't want to capture each track discreetly. Instead, we use subgroups to make stems that will be recorded individually, giving us a smaller recording channel count, while maintaining some control of the mix. Stems don't have to be sent to a recorder, however. There are plenty of situations where more than one mixer is used at an event. For instance, a mixer might be used to pre-mix a group of channels and then send that composite to the main mixer as stems to cut down on channel count in the main mix. This is called submixing. In technique 3, we are sending multiple subgroups to the same aux to create a blend of subgroups that can be delivered to an external device. This technique is useful for creating mix minus feeds in recording or broadcast scenarios. A mix minus output is a mix that includes all channels minus one or more channels subtracted for specific reasons. A common application for this is to prevent a caller from hearing themselves back through their phone call when calling in a radio show. Technique 3 can also be used to send mixes to remote feeds such as backstage spaces, house of worship overflow rooms, or lobby areas. If the event has video production involved, there might be a video control area that would need an audio feed specific to their needs. Teleprompter operators and interpreters are other common applications that would need a tailored audio feed. This technique is very similar to technique 1, but instead, we are using subgroups to build and control discrete mixes for different locations that may require more or less of certain groups. If we are sending a subgroup to an aux and want to remove it from the main mix, we can do so on the subgroup setup screen by deactivating the main LR assignment button. We might do this if there are elements of the mix that we only want to feed to certain outputs. Perhaps there is a click track or various vocal cues that need to be delivered to certain performers' in-ear monitors. Something like that would be vital to those performers, but you wouldn't want to hear that in the main output. Subgroups can also be used to simplify the performer's control over their in-ear monitor mixes. Instead of presenting faders for each individual channel, set up subgroups, drums, guitars, keys, horns, etc. Now, the performers have single fader control of these groups on their smartphones. This is even better if you use it with the custom fader banks, but that's a shameless plug for another video. Okay, so what if you have a TouchMix 8 or 16 and you're like, what? I want to use subgroups too. Well, you actually can. The TouchMix 8 and 16 both have the ability to send auxes to the main mix. With this feature engaged, the auxes essentially become subgroups. To do this, first choose a free aux to be used as the subgroup. Now, we need to set that aux output to post fader. For more information on what this means and how to set it up, you can check out our 4-part aux mix video series. You can find the link to those in the description below. Next, send the input channels you want to group to this aux and bring the faders up to unity. Depending on the application, we can choose whether we want to remove our input channels from the main mix. We now have all the processing available on the aux, and we can control the level of the group with the aux master fader. Bam! Subgroup. In addition, if you are using this to create stems that need to be sent out of the mixer, well, it's still an aux output, so it's all ready to do just that. That brings us to the end of our subgroups video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.